right here.
Obviously, it's a huge event, and I mean, the kids are all into it, everyone's into it. Last year is where things really turned around for me. I just started getting my tricks down. I just started learning new things, and I had a couple new moves that guys weren't doing, and I got to go to the X Games at that time and show everybody them. And that's the thing, is if you can come out to a big competition like that and do something that not everybody's doing, that's what's really going to get you recognized. Spokane, Washington, the 13th day of June. Caleb Wyatt is going to be trying a backflip off of this lip. Caleb's landing is a big hay pile. Going for the first ever backflip at exactly 10:40 in the day. No one's ever done it at 10:40 in the day, have they, Carter?
No one's done it.
Negative. What's up? Trying to make the plane in North Carolina. No, I was entirely hydroplaning. What's going on the freeway? No wheels on the ground. I'm trying to make it to the airport in time. We're late as usual. It's raining like it's never rained in San Diego before. And we're cutting people off, you know.
There's some freshies in the local mountains.
I don't know. Looking a little rough. Get on that. This ain't your plane either. Like, what are you talking about? Let's do this three times.
Bye.
so far. I'm still going. My foot's a little sore, but last time out, I kind of get the kinks out. I've got to ride for a while, but I think I'll be able to hopefully pull it off tonight. Seen that freestyle motocross contest? I ended up doing an autograph session at a honky shop there, and the guy comes up and says you can ride a street bike really good and wanted to do some tricks for us. And we're like, alright, go for it, you know. I was a little nervous because I've seen that stuff before and the guys wadded up. I didn't want that to happen, but once I saw the guy get out there and do his thing, he was really good. I don't think anybody's ever made it past me with a milk crate yet. I don't think they will. Fudge is just one of our friends that pretty much said we could build a jump out of this house, and it was right when we first started the sport.
We were all hanging out one night at the Oktoberfest, and Tommy and Jeff and Dean impressed the value of a jump somewhere close for them to practice with. Dean was stressing hard that I had some problems.
So we go out there. Build an 80-foot jump, first of all, dirt lip, dirt landing.
Not much pop, it just hit a third gear pretty fast, and, you know, we started just learning from there. You know, we each had a couple tricks, and we kind of built off that one double. We changed it up a little bit, made like 80 feet with a way steeper lip, and just kept going with it, and
all the contests started going to wooden ramps. So tilting with a tilting machine and welding. Came up with a ramp design and built our own ramp out there.
Ramp, I think, was probably the biggest factor in Tommy becoming the number one guy. I mean, he just, once we had a ramp, it was similar to what we were riding every week, and he just took off. He, you know, Tommy, I just watched the kid progress so fast. It blew me away, it pissed me off. But yeah, he just learned so much so fast, just took it to another level. And
Dane started jumping out here. This stuff has really progressed. Tyler King is jumping here now.
It's a little different going off a wood ramp than a dirt hit, you know, the angles are different. But it's also a lot easier because you have no ruts to deal with and things like that. So it's just evolved. I mean, that's what's really put us to the next level, is that jump. Because we just go out there a couple days a week and, you know, spend a couple hours and hit the jump, turn around, hit the jump, and that's where you get new tricks down. You go halfway with them until you feel comfortable, then you throw them out. So definitely Fudge has been a huge part in what we're doing.
Years ago, when we started doing this, we figured we'd be in trouble with everybody. Now, we can't do it enough. People want to see it more.
Here are the thrill seekers, the tough guys, corrupt and immoral.
They're catching me a little bit, so I threw the brakes on him, and I pretty much sealed the deal for him. Ocotillo is a place we've been going for years. We found a bunch of jumps out there, and it's just like a Disneyland for motocross. There's doubles everywhere, there's lips everywhere.
Tommy, he's been down there quite a bit, so it's fun going down with him. You know, you just gotta trust your bike off the lines and be able to read the terrain, and Tommy's a master at it, and it's fun riding down with him. And the thing that blows me away the most, really, is watching him do all these tricks out there, which is unbelievable. It's so hard to do tricks out of a natural terrain place like that. It's pretty amazing.
Anyway. in Ocotillo, though, I mean, there's more to it than just jumping. You can go the other side of the road. There's insane trails that we hit. I can't make it up a lot of them. We'll go, you know, blazing through sand washes, find new, you know, like canyons to go through, they snake through. Just go out there with your friends. Set up camp, campfire, stay overnight. It's kind of the whole, just get back to the basics and go out and ride your bike. I said I've been walking with my head up in the clouds. So afraid. Attempt number 2 by Caleb. Favorite sport would probably be golf.
I beat him by 10.
Find me, my friend.
tell us like what it entails, like what region,
right?
Santee. Was like riding out here, you know, growing up, all that whole history of this county.
Everyone knows East County, the El Cajon Zone, places where guys like Rick Johnson, Brock Glover, Ron Lachine, old schooler like Marty Tribes, Marty Smith, and there's been a lot of, Mike Craig, been a lot of guys that's come out of here. Santee, El Cajon, Lakeside is pretty much the East County area. A lot of riding growing up in the hills and stuff. It's kind of getting all shut down. Not really too many places to go anymore, but they opened up this track here in the heart of East County, El Cajon Speedway. This is the mecca of lifted trucks. If you've ever wanted a truck lifted, front high, back high, medium, too high.
Yeah. Tommy. Note to self, everyone in East County knows each other.
With your helmets on.
With helmets on.
Excellent out there. I was really pulling off some good lap times. I think everybody was great. Not a lot, but quite a few little things I do, but probably the most superstitious thing is dropping a new helmet when you get it before you ride with it. You gotta drop it on the ground, get the first fall out of the way. Hopefully it works. I got two screws in my left ankle, two screws in my right shoulder, collarbone twice, broke my scapula,
broke my, you know, tib, fib, my legs, wrist, had three things in there. This tooth's fake. Had about 5-6 concussions probably. For the most part, I guess it's not too bad for 20 years of riding.
Did you see the guy that ate it over there?
Yeah, I saw that.
What happened?
Yeah,
right?
Indo told, I don't know, he walked away and left his bike.
Here we are at Palm Ave. I grew up riding here since I was a kid. We go out and we ride the gnarliest, roughest tracks there are. Then we come out here and we play ride and have some fun. And this is what we have fun on. Good cliffs like this. A lot of people don't like this place. It's a little bit gnarly for them. But it's just something I'm used to. We grew up doing it.
One of the oldest riding spots in San Diego County. We go out there and it's got the roughest, gnarliest tracks you've ever seen, and it's got the gnarliest cliff jumps you've ever seen too. So we go out there and I remember a long time ago I'd be on my 80 and be jumping these cliffs and stuff that you know, I'd have my friends down there below spot me in case I don't make them, and a lot of times I didn't make them, but come back from riding and my dad would think I'm out there doing motos and my bike's all wadded up, bars bent. What happened? You know, I fell on a corner. Yeah, right. So I don't think he really believed that, but I think he's pumped I did it now because it's paying off now.
Oh.
it's in its last leg now. They're building houses everywhere, just like everything else. But I mean, it's still one of the legendary places in San Diego.
Backflip, depending on which one you're talking about, looks like I got one pretty all right, and the second one was a flop, but just got a big headache out of the deal, a little concussion, a couple bruised muscles, but all in all, I think it was a success.
Was pretty cool. One of many overseas trips I take every year. Things are really going big over there now.
My name is Stefan and we're driving to Riesa. From Leipzig to Riesa. About 40-50 minutes.
Sometimes you get lucky and there's some pretty good cheerleaders over there. That's one thing different in Europe than it is here. They definitely put on a good show. You come out, you're, you know, pushing the bike out, you got smoke everywhere, you can't really see. You just see a bunch of green lights flashing everywhere, techno beats. You know, it's like in a nightclub. They call your name, you come out, flares fly up, horns go off. The crazy just going out there. when you go to Europe, you know, you gotta definitely be flexible and be able to adapt to different things. Mike Jones, we're the U.S. riders there. We both drive for Red Bull, and we both pretty much are the two Americans that go to Europe the most. We'll be right back.
speed.
You guys gonna bust some crazy tricks tonight?
Yeah.
All right, it was 13, but you guys are cool, so now it's only like 6-something. So you guys all right, man?
And it was my turn to buy.
Can't be filming in here.
Godfrey event here in Salt Lake City. We're pulling up to it. This is actually a Greg Godfrey's trucking company right here.
We're sitting on top of the mesa. The step up's come up to you. The step up lip right here with these collars all piled up, about 140 feet from there to here. The six pack coming up through the middle. Do the step up, you drop down, 90 footer, another 90 footer, then you turn around, there's an 85 footer over here. And a little step down double right here into the ramp. Pretty technical course, a lot of big jumps, pretty good ramp to throw your tricks off of, so place is cool.
It's pretty fun. Fourth gear ones are pretty gnarly.
Come
down the hill,
but
like right when you get the bottom,
hold
it on.
It is like the floater.
And just go right before.
You can jump long and get the down.
That's all that. Pretty good.
I'm here, I mean, you know, Mike Jones always likes big jumps. Metzger, you never know what to expect from him. Well, our bikes are always having fun.
We'll be right back. catching up with me.